Hey guys, Tony in Tennessee sent me these, a few pieces of this, I don't know if it's a variety of Fort Payne or exactly what it is, a rock from Tennessee that he's found, and it's really good quality stone. It has a little bit of a soft quality to it, and maybe he'll figure out more about what kind of rock it is, but he sent me a few pieces to try and asked if I'd make a point and film it, so hopefully I can make something pretty decent. I'm going to start with the Hammerstone. I think I'm going to try to make a knobbed hardin. I was going to make a Clovis, but I think I've done so much Clovis work lately, I kind of feel like doing something else. So I'd like to make a wider knobbed hardin and do some Hammerstone work to make a blank, and then do some antler direct percussion, and then finish the blade edges and notching with probably a straight antler punch. So I'm going to start with this gritty sandstone Hammerstone to make a blank. This cortex is soft, so I'll have to see how well this Hammerstone works to remove it, but let's just start. And these early flakes, I'm going to use the middle part of the Hammerstone, and you know, I'm not going to be hitting right on the end, I'm going to be sort of hitting on the middle. Might need to switch to a harder Hammerstone and get started. There. The cortex is soft. Kind of have to just turn it. Now that I've got my angle, I can move some flakes across here. These little abrading brushing strikes just to dull the edge. Take one flake and I'll just trim up and go over. Those little brushing strikes sort of move that platform over. That overshot a little bit, but didn't. Where it did lose the edge, it was just mostly cortex, so it didn't really hurt anything. We'll just use that edge that just overshot. Now we'll just trim that down. This, I was thinking about hitting this, but it's too steep. I'm gonna take another flake down here to get that angle right, and then back across. There. I made it a little less steep. And the edge is wavy. I'll do a little blending, you know, just blend this in, get a little flake back there, just trim a little bit there, probably just a small one here to build that, and get that set up. Just a little blending here, and over back the other way, just a little bit here. See how that straightened the edge up? I could still do maybe a teeny bit of blending there and get this ridge set up, but I'll leave that for now and work on the ends. But right now, just a couple flakes, and it's you know, starting to get to be an organized preform. Turning the edges, just brushing. Just building contours, just little flakes I'll move down and probably get another little flake here and then I can get a big one on the ridge. See those little blenders? Now this is the area we're gonna wanna hit, but this is a little high, so let's just trim that down. There. Now I'm gonna take just a flake here. That's a lot of thickness to try to remove here, so I'll take a little flake there. Push this down. See that? Okay, now I'll just get everything set up. Take a teeny one there. Push it down. Get everything nice and smooth. Get my platform right. See how I did that? Now look at that nice edge. Platform to follow that ridge. Make it a little bit steeper. Support that really well. That's just the flake I needed there. Just, you know, went to there, but it just smoothed it out. Okay. I want to keep my length on this, but there's a, it's still really heavy on the tip, so let's take a little flake off of here, and that'll get an angle to thin this tip down. Right now I can't just abrade this and hit there, I'm a little bit too high, so trim it down. Just a little brush. It's on the Cortex, so it'll be pretty soft. I can put my fingers under there, and this is really Cortex-y, so I'm gonna hope I get a clean flake off and doesn't just crush. Got a little one. There. Now we'll go ahead and take another flake back up here to lower that just a little bit and get another flake down at the tip. If it's too cork soft, I'll just might have to lose a teeny bit of length here. I'm gonna go inside, Rico. Hold on. Dog got a haircut and it's a little bit chilly out here for him. He's not exactly a tough Arkansas dog. Okay, I lost a little bit of length. Held it flat in my hand and hit it fairly flat with the Hammerstone. Took a flake down the tip. Now the rest of that Cortex is gone, so I did lose a little bit of length, though not anything too bad. Now that last little square area, we'll just brush it down and then take another little flake here. Pretty soon I'm gonna have to switch to a smaller Hammerstone or antler. This material, you could work with wood even. It's soft and big pieces of this wood would work excellent. See those nice little flakes to just trim and move the edge over and blend in? The Hammerstone. These are just so important. If you're using copper on these, then you know the edges are going to be a little bit different. And if you use Hammerstones, you want to use the Hammerstone for an abrader and not a synthetic abrading stone. So that little blender that I just took off the other side, I just took another. And the flake there, it's getting a little bit straighter. I've got plenty of good width here. Hope this is showing up okay. Get a little blender here. Maybe just raise it one more. There. Maybe just move another one. Sometimes you need to do a little brushing just to come back. Do the little blending flicks. Blending back and forth. Edges are getting straighter and I'm turning it. The edges down towards the areas that have a thicker mass and ridges. And at the same time, creating contours on the other face. When I come back, it'll be ready. Now that we did all that, we've got this edge, it's turned down along this mass, we can blend it in, and the same thing on this side. So I think I'll start down here at the corner, a couple more. To do a little turn. There. I see that nice little platform there. Hold my finger underneath it. Catch the middle part of the hammerstone. Supported it. I caught just a little bit extra off the edge with the even support underneath. I removed a nice flake. Now we can just do a spacer. On the next flake, there's a little bit of a ridge right here. Just a teeny bump right here. So I don't know if you can see that. I can just do a little teeny turn flake. There we go. I can just do a little blender spacer support. A little spacer. Just where I need to just do a little brush down, turn it back. Okay, this is a good platform here, but I've got an area that's kind of flat and some more mass here. And if I really, with this large a hammerstone, if I drive that into my hand, I can get a bad overshot here. So let's go ahead and go to the other side and trim back into that. Well, we had the cortex that overshot before because it was a little softer. Let's just go ahead and... I didn't know that flake was going to go quite that far, but... It's okay, there's a little hole in there. But I don't think it goes all the way through, and I don't think it'll cause a problem. Now that we did that, if like here, we can now turn back over and just blend in from these platforms. Grind down, get another one. There. And very nice. Isolate that a little bit. It's nice and flat, so we can just grind it. A lot of times the platforms, I'll put a little back grind on it to create a little small, little steeper bevel on that edge. This is one of the last flakes I'm going to take with this Hammerstone. This Hammerstone is just, it's overkill. It's awful heavy. Nice little flake. And let's just blend in from the other side into that. I totally missed that platform, but it was set up okay anyway. The accuracy with the bigger Hammerstones is not quite as good. So we'll just take this one more little blender and then we'll set this Hammerstone down. Missed it again. There. I took out a little bit more thickness than I needed, but it's fine. We'll just do two. Since that I did that flake, I'll just get a couple more flakes off the back here. Down a little bit. Get a good grind. Okay. There. That's nice. Just a teeny one here. And one more. One teeny one. There. Okay. That's probably the end stage with this big Hammerstone. You can see this Hammerstone is longer than the preform, so the big Hammerstones work great to make quick work of these blanks to this stage, and then you can keep going with them, but your platforms tend to get so wide because of the facets on these that it's better to switch to a smaller Hammerstone. I'm going to stop the camera here.